Yesterday was the happiest day of my life. We just virtually told nobody. My sister and Brian's sister attended with us. So I started yesterday morning having a budget meeting with the Taoiseach and the Minister of Finance. And then we had a normal day until 4:05 when I left the Beat Talks and went off and got married at 5:20.
Preserve, protect, and defend the Constitution of the United States.
Preserve, protect, and defend the Constitution of the United States.
So help me God.
So help me God.
A keep that was built in 1430, ruined in about 1603, and had remained ruined. And we're almost finished bringing it back to life.
I'm told, Taoiseach, when you played, you were a clogger. You played left fullback, isn't that right?
I did, yeah. But
for Home Farm and for drums.
Home Farm and afterward for drums. But I always kept my elbows under control. Now and again, they got a bit.
Well, there was no elbows flying in those days, but the boots, Taoiseach.
Yeah, well, I played it hard. You had to in junior football. There was no other way of doing it. You had to protect yourself.
I'm glad you've cleared up this controversy about your kicking days. Two kickers. For the first time ever, I'm not the worst player in the studio. There's the worst player in the studio.
Stadium Ireland, Campus and Stadium Ireland, Bertie's Bow, whatever you want to call it, one thing's sure, it's divided the nation. In this week's Irish Times MOBI opinion poll, the public is virtually evenly divided on whether to build a national stadium or spend the money on other sports facilities throughout the state.
This is a magnificent facility. This is going to be the biggest, most significant development, maybe the largest development in the history of the state.
I see now who are writing about this every day. I've never seen them in 40 years going to all kinds of sport. I've never seen them at anything. I've never seen them at a Tilly Wink match or an international match. And now they're experts.
Yeah. like to pray to her for her intention and just pay my respects to her.
I'm here because I live right across the road and it's an amazing privilege to have a saint on my doorstep. I may never ever get this chance again.
Maybe she'd work a few miracles for us.
This is not a demonstration. This is not a cause that we've taken up. This is education, and this is fundamental to any society that calls itself civilized.
This is loving.
No excuse for this officer lying over here on the ground, and he's not the first one this week, but, you know, that is bad enough, but to do it whenever children are on their way to school, you know, I just am sick to the pit of my stomach.
This year's loving, it lasts. 'Cause who's to worry if our hearts get torn when it gets thrown? Don't you know this life goes on? Won't you kiss me?
What I want to do is to ensure that what is a major emergency does not turn into a disaster.
This year's love, it lasts. This year's love, it lasts.
This is a major disappointment for all concerned, for the country at large, for the agri-business, for the agri-tourism business, for sporting and cultural organisations.
There'll
not be a sheep left in the country.
Yeah. And you've been through it all, you've seen it yourself.
I mean, I've waited 70 years.
It's all right, Jack.
And you look forward to this time of year with the lamb. And, you know, the lamb is playing in the field and out early in the morning. Yeah. Now all you'll hear is the birds. Not a lamb or a sheep to be heard.
I never thought you would. In close attendance. Keane is fouled. Duff helping it on towards Finnan. Finnan facing Cuckoo. And a little cross in there, and it's come through here. McAteer! Amsterdam revisited. Mick McCarthy's big gamble. Jason McAteer gets the goal. There has been agony this afternoon. Now there is ecstasy.
This is a pain in the heel being in anyway.
You're right there.
That must be some Irish parent or anything, you know. There must be, you know. What was the name of that place? It's DVB, Phil and Cuba.
O'Shake with Paris.
Yeah.
What's the name of it?
There must be an O'Shake of Paris or an Ali Cahaz or something.
Well, there's going to be no O'Shake of Paris or Ali Cahaz or around you, boom, booms, right in around you. No, where'd they go? Because it's against their religion. Now, will you get that into the wet piece of bog roll you call a brain?
It's against my religion not to have a gargle on the day of the match.
This Irish team, which thoroughly deserves its place.
I might articulate it better tomorrow, later, when I'm not as emotional.
Yeah, it looks like a little bit of tear in your eye, an unusual thing that for Mick McCarthy.
Hard man's gone soft there. What do you expect? We've worked a long time. Wonderful group of players. Fabulous staff. I think they deserve it. They deserve it as much, if not more, than me.
People are doing very well in the economy, but anecdotally, without any empirical evidence, we could all agree that people don't provide as much for the rainy day as they used to in the past. What took you so long? What took you all night? What took you forever to see? I'm back, and now I treat you so good. I make you feel fine. You know I'll never give it up this time. We have a number of people in our corridor throughout Ireland and throughout the world, it says, which would say that the way that Ireland has conducted its economic affairs in recent years should be copied by more member states of the European Union. And if that was the case, we'd have a very stronger European growth rate and consequently a very stronger euro.
Does that agreement mean anything in practice? The only finance minister to give Mr. McCreevy any direction on that subject was Didier Reynders of Belgium, who said either cut spending or don't cut taxes, advice that's likely to be ignored. What took you so long?
What clearly has to happen is we have to try and assess
the sort of concerns and anxieties that people have, which are not directly related to the Treaty of Nice at all, try and assimilate those and see in what way they can be reflected in our future discussions with European colleagues.
We're a sovereign nation. We don't, for 700 years, we didn't take lying down too easily. And I think the result of the referendum can be looked at as a positive thing.
And this would be the lounge study area. We got a piano, a big pile of books. Get nice sun in there in the morning, which is really kind of nice.
Is it safe?
Oh, yeah, very safe. More decoration, really. Come on, yeah.
This adaptation that they talk about, I'm already adapted, so I love space.
Right now, and the worst moment is going to be in about 30 seconds time when I have to get off the boat and walk up the pontoon and I don't want to say goodbye to her.
Maloney trying to get that ball away from danger. Colin Joyce winning it back. Here's Charles Fallon. Oh, he puts it beautifully in the ball. Joyce, can he turn? Plays it back well. And it's picked over by Joe Bergen. The jubilant captain of the Premier County in 2001.
we've had a national tragedy. Two airplanes have crashed into the World Trade Center in an apparent terrorist attack on our country. Carry this. It is the police shield of a man named George Howard, who died at the World Trade Center trying to save others. It was given to me by his mom, Arlene, as a proud memorial to her son. It is my reminder of lives that ended and a task that does not end.
We've struck several terrorist training camps. We've damaged most of the airfields, I believe all but one.
Do you think we are to getting Osama bin Laden?
We're a heck of a lot closer today than we were 60 days ago. And he thinks he can run and he thinks he can hide, but he's not going to be able to, so we'll get him.